Which brings us to another quite different story about chance and what kids actually get for their money. Gum cards have been with us a long time, more than 100 years, in fact. And during this time, kids of all ages have bought and swapped their favorites, everything from movie stars to sport heroes. Of course, the fun of card collecting is trying to get a full set.
But did you ever wonder what the chances of collecting all the cards in a set are? Well, Reinhold, Becky, and Benji Honsbein of Rolly View, Alberta are card collectors who wonder just that after a disappointing experience with Gremlins. Cards, that is. Each wanted all 82 cards in the Gremlin set. Well, being experienced collectors, they didn't fool around buying a few packs of cards at a time. Instead, they went right to the wholesaler and bought two cartons, a total of 576 cards.
Back at home, the Honsbeins sat down to divvy up the loot. From past experiences, they expected to get several complete sets out of two cartons, at least one set for each of them. They were in for a surprise.
When the counting was finished, the Honsbeins had only one complete set. The problem was the distribution of the cards. Out of two cartons, they got 21 nasty Mrs. Beagles and only one little Gizmo.
Feeling a little nasty himself, Mr. Honsbein wrote the Canadian distributor of the cards, O-Pee-Chee Limited of London, Ontario. He said,
"The selling price of a pack of cards has gone from 25 cents to 35 cents, an increase of 40%. That's bad enough. But your method of distributing the cards within a carton is unfair and outrageously inflationary."
Our family of card collectors ended up paying $18.90 for their one set of Gremlins. They asked the company,
"Is this a fair price for 82 cards? If one cannot get even one set from a carton, what chance has a person who buys one or two packs at a time? It would seem that a lot of kids of whatever age are being ripped off while hoping to obtain a complete set."
O-Pee-Chee responded quickly to the Honsbein's charge of kiddie exploitation. The company rushed complimentary sets of cards and this explanation to our disgruntled family.
"The card distribution is done totally at random and should result in several sets of cards per box. Your experience is extremely rare."
Well, just how rare is it?
Good question. To find out, we've invited two expert card collectors to do a special marketplace survey. Adam and Michael here have been counting cards from two cartons of Gremlins. How's it going?
We haven't got a complete set yet.
We'll keep on counting.
Keep on counting. We'll check with you later in the show. And now, ta-da, the results of our special marketplace gum card survey. If you recall, the distributor of Gremlins, the O-Pee-Chee Company, said you should get several complete sets of cards per box.
Our experts here have been counting almost 600 cards, and I believe, yes, they have the results for us.
Okay, first of all, Michael, what did you get?
In the first box, we got one complete set.
One set. How about you, Adam?
And also in the second box, we only got one complete set.
So two cartons, two sets. You did twice as well as the Honsbeins did, but not nearly so well as the manufacturer said we should have done. There it is, another marketplace exclusive.
Gum card collectors, be warned.
We'll be back next week with an update on the hazards of split wheel rims on some trucks and campers, along with lots, lots more consumer information.
In the meantime, we'd like to hear from you. Write to us at Box 2000, Station A, Toronto, M5W2A2. That's Marketplace, Box 2000, Station A, Toronto, M5W2A2. And now, good night.
Good night. Good night, fellas.
This is CBC.